Hello and greetings from Iceland. As most of you know already, eruption number 11 started yesterday and it came to an end only a few hours later. Or did it? That is the main question of the day, because what we have now is something that was not expected. So my coverage today will cover the big picture rather than to repeat what others were doing yesterday during this fast and furious day. And I took off from the north as soon as the earthquake started yesterday. And after the first 50 kilometers of the 400, I had to drive the eruption started. And since it's not a good idea to be watching TV while I'm driving, a friend of mine called me every now and then. And I have to say that for a while yesterday, I thought that this was all over for the town. So this was not a pleasant drive, to be honest. And like I've been mentioning in my last updates, the longer we have to wait, the bigger the surprise could get. And that was exactly what happened. So this is not over. And just 2 days ago, we had more magma accumulated under Svartsengi than ever before. And the fissure that opened up by town was very short. And even so, the eruption was weak. So shortly after this started, one of the experts was talking about that this might be something like the Fagradalsfjall eruption, the first one in 2021, or a relatively small eruption that could go on for a long time, which would of course have meant that we could say goodbye to the harbor in Grindavík, and if the harbor goes, the town goes with it. And as I drove further south yesterday, so did the erupting fissure, moving south closer to the town. So this looked awful. But lucky us, this had flamed out in the afternoon. And it makes perfect sense to me what Professor Magnus Tumi Guðmundsson has been saying when he called this just a little leakage from the main event that could be still in the making. And the main event, that could be this earthquake swarm that was moving to the northeast all day, yesterday. And experts say now that what we got yesterday was a new magma dike up to 20 kilometers long, perhaps around 5 kilometers down. So in a way, this looks a bit like the 2023 rifting event. We expected a volcanic eruption back then, but the magma never found its way up and formed a large magma dike that literally split the town Grindavík. In fact, the magma dike from 2023, more magma went into filling it in November than would later emerge during the two largest eruptions combined. And what we got yesterday is in a way a similar thing, apart from this leakage or this small eruption. There are a few new fractures in Grindavík now, but nothing like in 2023 though. But it has, however, caused some damages. We know so far about at least one hot water pipeline. But this does, however, look better for the town now than yesterday. But the most important location now, the total surprise, is of course here. We still don't know how much of the magma from the reservoir it holds. But one data point from one day is not enough to say how much, so I'm going to leave that for later until we get more information. But this is how the magma spread out underground the last 24 hours. So this location here, with this drone angle, was of course my main point of interest yesterday, and I could feel many earthquakes while I was there. And this is the so-called Grindavíkur gjá, or the Grindavík fracture. And this is not the only fracture around. All this land is extremely fractured. And Professor Magnus Tumi, he was saying that this area could erupt, but it would likely not be a large eruption. There are, however, other experts like Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson. He mentioned yesterday that this could be a tectonic displacement, but not magma. But either way, this is already a major twist to this already complicated story. And to get a volcanic eruption around 1 kilometer away from Iceland's busiest highway, that can be very distracting, even for responsible drivers. But luckily, as for the tourism, there are other ways to get to the airport. So this scenario is not about to interrupt international flights. And none of those 11 eruptions have done so, actually. And you got another surprise on the westernmost part of the peninsula, or somewhere around magnitude 5 earthquake. And if we look at that one in the time-lapse format, it looks as not unlikely that the magma chamber deflating was causing some tension changes there. But the area there is, however, a separate system with its own set of events going on there. So we can't be sure what is exactly happening there and how that relates to this. And the strangest earthquake plot of the day has to be the Sundhnúkur craters. This gap, it used to be the earthquake hotspot, but it was left out this time. So there are some dynamics there that are changing for sure. And despite the fact that the day ended well, it left us with likely more questions than ever before. So we are moving into yet another journey of uncertainty because this small and short eruption, it was not the main event as things look now. But as for the big picture, the magma inflow into the reservoir has decreased a whole lot recently. And if it continues to decrease after this eruption, that could confirm that, that this is coming to an end. But if the inflow will however increase again after this event, that would leave us back to square one almost, where we would not just still be facing a disaster in Grindavík and the Blue Lagoon and the power plant. We would have to add the main power line to the Reykjanes Peninsula into the package. You can see it here, and Iceland's busiest highway as well, or where the earthquakes are hammering the ground right now, or while I was filming this yesterday. And my last flight of the day yesterday was supposed to be a thermal drone tour, but that drone is very sensitive if the batteries are cold. Since the drone had been in my car all day, it decided to end the trip on its own and send me on a hiking tour. And after I got back to town, it was just getting too late to do this video, plus I needed more information. And it is my plan to do a thermal drone tour there today, if the sun won't shine too much, over the Grindavík fracture. But I do not expect to get any results. This would be more, the magma is still very deep down, so that footage would be categorized as the before footage, if the magma will try to find its way to the surface. And the thermal drone detects only the surface temperature, of course, but it's those fractures that I'm thinking about. Or if it's possible that the drone could detect something. And it's only one way to find out. And my original plan was to stay here for 2 or 3 days, get videos from the eruption itself, but we got this surprise, so I might stay here until next week while I see how this develops. And since I know that the scientists are working hard on this data and we are in this very sensitive situation, my next update will be very soon. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.